Welcome, and welcome back to the latest edition of Brandler Bits. I'm Jeff Brandler. There's been a constant ongoing theme on Brandler Bits, which is pretty obvious by now if you're a regular listener, that our lives are most affected by the other people in it. Our relationships, our interpersonal relationships, are the key ingredient that leads to our own happiness. Some of our own happiness comes from within, for sure. But since we don't live in the mountains someplace and we have to interact with other people, our stress comes from other people, our happiness comes from other people, our joy comes from being around and experiencing other things with other people. So today on Brandler Bits, we're going to look at some of the people who may be in your life who we will describe as a difficult person. We all have difficult people in our lives. So what and who and what do we do about these difficult people? That's what we're going to talk about today. We know who difficult people are. There are family members. There are bosses. There are significant others. There are friends. There's a whole bunch of them. And if you think about it, we spend a lot of mental energy dealing with these people who we will describe as difficult. If you had to think out loud, what kinds of behaviors make people difficult? Some of them are hostile or aggressive. Some of them are negative or pessimistic. Some of them are withdrawn or passive. Some people are overly agreeable, but they don't deliver. Let's call them passive aggressive. And some of them are highly opinionated and highly defensive. So your interactions with these folks who are difficult are always going to be difficult because they cause great stress. They cause great agita inside, and there is always Aunt Agnes who we have to deal with at Thanksgiving. There's always Mary Sue who shows up at the family barbecue. There is always Billy Bob who shows up when we don't want him to. These are the folks in our lives that are difficult. And in fact, if you have a job where you see these folks every day, it makes it rather draining. It makes it rather exhausting. If perchance one of these difficult people is your spouse or significant other, that's a whole nother conversation, but sure, they will be very, very difficult to deal with. So having said that, what are some things we can do about some of these difficult people that exist in our lives? Well, the first thing that we need to have is boundaries. We need to set some very clear boundaries, some very clear limits about how I'm going to interact with these people. Because if I feel bad being around this person, I don't want to be around this person. Period. End of conversation. If there's some obligatory reason that I have to be there, then I want to limit my exposure to that person. I want to limit the amount of time that I have to see this person. I want to put lots of insulation, other people, other activities around this person. So what I don't want to do is go mano a mano with this difficult person for all day or all week or a vacation because I'll lose my mind. I need some boundaries. Make it a short stay, short visit, put other people, other activities way more doable. When you're dealing with people that are difficult, you need to communicate clearly. You need to use what we call I statements. I think, I feel, I need to, I want to. Because then it's I, not you, because you's a fighting word, and they will take every opportunity to pick a fight, start a fight, exaggerate a fight. But if I say, hey, I'm really upset by the comment you made yesterday, period, I've just communicated pretty clearly. The other things that these difficult people do is they love to push buttons. And so when they push buttons, they get stuck inside. So the metaphor that I've always used is the old school heavy duty iron skillet that everything sticks to. So this person says that it gets stuck there. You can't clean that frying pan. You cannot clean that skillet. You can scrub it, but it's never going to come off. Those stains, those pains, those scars stay forever. So you need to come up with a little more Teflon in your life so that these comments, these actions start sliding off. A little more Teflon. The other thing that you can also do is recognize that if you have a difficult person, they are always going to be difficult. They're not going to not be difficult. They're going to be difficult. So if you recognize and accept that keyword, accept that they are starring as themselves, they can't be anybody else. They are starring as themselves. They are going to be difficult. And if you accept that, you have accomplished an awful lot. So let's take it a little bit deeper. Let's examine the question, why does this person bother me so much? Do they remind me of anybody? Do they remind me of anybody significant? Do they remind me of anybody significant from my own past? Why does this person bother me? Sometimes like, oh, now I know why this person bothers me. And it's the aha moment that people come up with when they connect the dots and say, oh, this person reminds my mom. This person reminds my dad. Oh, this person's my grandfather. Oh, he was a real bastard. Oh, now I got it. So that insight, that development starts to connect some other things and starts to connect some other things that make change happen. Note, the difficult person in your life is the person who is in your life to help you to be a better person. What? Say that again. The person who is difficult in your life is here to help you be a better person. So the person who you view as being difficult may just be that opportunity that you need in order to look deeper at some long-standing issues to connect you to your past and help you to grow in the future. If you have any questions about today's Brandler Bits, feel free to contact me. The best way to do that is my website, which is www.changeispossible.org. I'm Jeff Brandler. This is Brandler Bits. See you soon.